first game tonight, we are playing the name game. So it's very simple. All I want to do is just stand in the circle. We stand legs apart, and all I want to do is put your hands in their red to catch. So what it is when we throw it around, you're going to shout your own name. All right? So I throw it and I shout, Stuart. And I'd then put my hands down. All you're going to do is you're going to throw the ball somewhere else and shout your own name. So give it a wee go.
Emma.
You've got to remember who you received from and then who you passed to. And the ball will always come back to me to start. And we'll build up for there. So good to start? Easy enough? Any questions?
No?
Okay. No? Good. Right, so ready? Hands up. We'll go the same way as teams. Ready? So it's Stuart.
Emma.
Harry.
You.
Oh wait.
Ella.
So we'll go round that one again, right? So nice throws, we know who it's coming from, know who it's going to. We ready?
Stuart.
We're going to add in, we're adding in another object. So now there's going to be two going, okay? So you're focusing again, look at that come across, try and avoid them hitting each other, but again, nice and easy throws, all right? Now ready? Stuart.
Emma.
Ready? Stuart.
Emma.
Hello.
Right, three items now. Stuart.
Emma.
Stuart.
Emma.
Stuart.
Hello.
Guys, that's amazing. Right. We've now got a little furry ball. It's a smaller one, that's its wee brother. All right. We ready? Four. Four going. We ready? Stuart. Stuart.
Emma.
Remember, shout your name. Right, last one. We're going to go with five.
Stuart. Stuart.
Stuart.
Stuart.
Amazing.
Hey.
Well done. Well done. That was excellent. That was excellent. Guys, so second game is just called colours, and use a parachute. The setters went up, all we do is divide into even teams. So we've got yellow, white, orange, red and blue. Make sure we stand round and we're not standing next to the same colour. What's going to happen is we pick a parachute up. If I shout small, we do wee small movements. If I shout big, we do big massive movements. If I shout down, we go down. If I shout up, we'll have it as high as we can. I'll then shout a colour, and you have to run around clockwise back to your same bit before the parachute hits the ground. All right, so a quick wee demo. So again, you can pick it up if you want, pick up by the handles, or you can just hold the parachute. All right, we're going to shout small. We're going to stay big. We're going to go down. Good. We're going to go up. I'm going to shout red. Right guys, this time we're going to try with two colours. Alright? We'll have a go this time. Small, and up, and down. Oh, am I going to go blue and white? Blue and white, blue and white. Oh. Oh. Oh, I love that, I love that. Right, so this time, rather than go round, you're going to go under the parachute and just swap positions. If it was red, you'd swap the red. If it was orange, you'd swap the orange again. Then we're under it, we're going to be ducking. Then just make sure you can keep your eyes up. Don't run into anyone. And we'll be nice and soft here, all right? So same instructions, small, big, up, down. This time, round, go round, you're going under, all right? Ready, so start with small. We're going to go up, we're going to go yellow. Well done. We're going to go with two colours, and I'll try and remember my colours. We're ready? We're going wee. Nice and wee. Let's go big. Let's go down. Let's go up. Red and blue. Oh. Nice. Try three. Okay, we're ready? We're going to go big. Let's go up. We're going to go up. We're going to go down. We're going to go up. Red, white, orange. Well done, team. Well done. So next game is just called Balloon Pop. So you should have a balloon and a piece of string, okay? First instruction is all you do is take the string and go tie it round the knot of the balloon. To make sure it doesn't come off, if you want to add in a second knot, okay? So once you have your balloon on, all you want to do is pick your favourite leg. Mine's my left, but I'll use my right. Am I going to use the same knot, just loosely round your ankle? You should be able to get one finger in between your leg and the string, okay? So as you can see, we've got different lengths, and that's absolutely fine. All you do is you drop your balloon. The simple game is, all we've got to do is, when I shout go, you've just got to try and pop someone else's balloon, okay? So an example would be, I'm not going to do it though, I would come across and I would try and stamp on that balloon. We don't want to contact aim, don't want to kick aim in the leg, we're aiming for the balloon, okay? Again, this game, you're never out. We'd never want you out. So if your balloon gets burst, you're not out of the game, you just go and try and get somebody else's balloon. The winner is the last person standing with their balloon intact. Any questions? Good to go? Good to go. So in 3, 2, 1, go! Let's go for me, Aaron. We have a winner.
This is the cone grab game, and first person to grab the cone and put it above the head wins. Face your partner. You put your hands out, make sure your fingers are touching. I'm going to say head, shoulders, knees or toes, or even belly, and first person to grab it wins. Head, shoulders, toes, knees, cone. And it's best of three. Knees, shoulders, head, belly, cone. Toes, shoulders, head, belly, cone.
I've gave everybody a pen and they put it behind them. So if I shout pen, you turn around and put it in the cone.
The first person to put it in the cone wins.
Head, shoulders, belly, toes, pen.
We've handed out everyone a piece of paper, and now you just fold it into a ball. And once you've done that, put it behind the pen, like one step back after it. I'm going to shout cone, pen, or paper. And if that's the paper, you pick it up, and first person to hit your partner with it wins. So let's go. Knees, belly, ears, nose, toes. Paper.
Oh,
Okay, so this game is called Side to Side.
So the first person with the balloon will turn stage way, and then you turn around and then you pass it opposite ways all the way to the back.
And the person at the back takes the balloon, runs up, goes there and goes to the front, and then you just do it again. And then the first team to the yellow cone wins.
You ready?
3, 2, 1, go.
You come that were a new group to us in 2021, and we come along and we'd love a 6-week youth work session which involved Kelly Kettles, den building, arts and crafts, special effects, just to provide a kind of 6-week input to show them different opportunities that they could learn through youth work and show the guys at Newcomnock what they can do in different activities. We came along and delivered, I think there was over 70 kids come along nearly every week. We were inside, we were outside, doing so many different activities, and it was fantastic for us and fantastic for Newcomnock Development Trust as well. I think it's absolutely amazing, mate. We get to go in and see different kids and young people work along, listen to their ideas, deliver what they want, give new experiences to kids they might never have had before. We look to go in and give groups some new ideas, some new content, and just support them, develop and grow or sustain their membership. And I think it's really important to build the partnerships like with Newcomnock and other groups within myself, within Ayrshire, but within Scotland as well.
I enjoyed today's session. We got to do a lot of different activities. It was actually quite fun. Got all our energy out and everything. It can be fun to be more active, and it's good to do new things.
I really enjoy it because it's made me have more fun activities and demonstrate it to folk. We've kind of learned to do like all kind of things, like milkshake making, special effects and all that kind of stuff, so we can learn new things.
Aye, it was quite good. I enjoyed it. We went on a trip to this like fun day thing with all the bouncy castles. It was quite good.
Newcomnock Development Trust has worked in partnership with Youth Scotland, and in particular Stuart, for about the past 6 or 7 months. Youth Work is a brand new partnership and stream to our organisation, and the support for Youth Scotland has been invaluable. We couldn't have progressed. We now support up to almost 100 young people a week, and without the support for Youth Scotland and Stuart, that wouldn't be possible. I think it's great, particularly where we come from. If you don't have a standout hobby like dancing or football or something like that, it's really hard to find an interest for young people. So having sessions like this where it varies week to week and the kids get a lot of input about what we do every week, it's really important to them. It gives them a voice, a wee bit decision making as well, takes the pressure off us, and it's always fun.